FEMA Administrator Pete Gaynor joins us now from the National Response Coordination Center in Washington, D.C. Good morning, Mr. Gaynor. We have to stop meeting like this. Listen, you were here 3 weeks ago. We were talking about Hurricane Laura at the time, so I know you know this song. You know all the words. What is the difference with this hurricane? What's your biggest concern with Sally?
Well, you know, I think today the message is there's still time to heed the directions of your local elected officials and emergency managers. So if you're under evacuation orders, you know, please heed that, you know, those orders. The other thing is you still have time to make final preparations. You need to do that quickly. And again, this storm is going to be a slow-moving storm, lots of surge, and really, more importantly, lots of rain, especially inland. Rain, I think, because it's such a slow mover, is going to be the major issue as we move, Sally, through Alabama and Georgia in the next couple days.
Yeah, slow-moving storms, we keep hearing, are the worst. Where are you focusing your efforts on right now?
Well, the president yesterday approved emergency declarations for Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi to make sure that those governors and those emergency managers have all the resources they need to do to conduct emergency protective measures. So we're coordinating with the states right now. We have a significant footprint in Louisiana because of Hurricane Laura. So we're well postured. We're leaning into it to make sure that we meet all the needs of all those three states.
Did you learn anything, Pete, from Hurricane Laura 3 weeks ago that is helping you deal with Sally now?
Well, I think no matter if it's Laura or whatever storm, we try to learn lessons from everything that we do. You know, this business of emergency management is an imperfect business, and so, you know, some things we do really well at and some things we wish we did a little bit better. So we take all those lessons learned and plow them back in. I think, especially in a COVID environment, we're learning lessons each time we have one of those challenges. And so, you know, the majority of evacuees going to hotels, and there's some problems with that because in some cases you displace the ability to house, like, utility workers, right? So we're making those adjustments. And again, we work closely with the states, the locals, and the tribes to get to that that more perfect solution.
Yeah, let's talk about the COVID environment because, you know, it is still thriving in this country. Is that affecting FEMA's efforts and affecting your resources?
Well, we actually, you know, way back when we were put in charge from, by the president to manage the COVID response, we knew that hurricane season was coming. So we gave planning documents, considerations to locals to, you know, adapt their plans to the COVID environment. And states and locals are doing it. You know, there are challenges with that, but I'm pretty pleased from what I've seen across the country. So whether it's wildfires or it's hurricanes, states and locals have adapted to the new COVID environment when it comes to these natural hazards.
Listen, Pete, listening to you this morning, it sounds like what you're saying is FEMA has it under control. You feel as confident as you sound?
Well, this is a team effort. So it's just not FEMA. It's my local state partners. It's my federal partners. So on the ground, it's just not FEMA personnel, but it is really the whole federal family and our private partners. We've been at this a while now. We're about to run out of letters for hurricanes,
yeah,
which I guess
is
another historic challenge. But I have a great team. I have full confidence, not only in the federal team, but my partners that are on the ground today.
All right, Pete Gaynor, thank you very much for your time today.